Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about higher frequency diffusion. In most of our discussions, we talk about vertical, horizontal, two-dimensional, one-dimensional diffusion. And that's a diffusion that is quadratic, and it's based on some prime numbers. And we know from our math training, hopefully, that prime number is a number divisible by itself in 1. 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, those are the six sequences that we use, and we offer the DIY build plans for them, and you can buy the finished units from us also. But the calculations are based on a formula, a modulus formula, which too complicated to go into, but it's basically a division and a subtraction with a residue, and that determines the well depth. So you can look that up. Just look up modulus and you'll get some information on that. The frequency response in most of our diffusers that we use on a regular basis averages from 200 to 3450 in frequency response. And we know that the well depth of the diffuser determines the low end, and the well width determines the upper frequencies at which the diffusion occurs. So the deeper the diffuser, the lower the frequency response. So as a general rule, the difference between a 7, 11, and a 13 is about one octave between a 7 and 11, another octave between 11 and 13, et cetera, et cetera. So it diminishes after you get a little bit higher up in the prime numbers, but I'll give you an idea. A diffuser that goes down to 100 cycles is almost 3 feet deep. So, because it's based on quarter length, right? And a 100 cycle wave is 11 foot. So 3 foot is about 25% of it. So, but what about the frequencies above 3450? What about those 4,000, those 5,000, those 6,000 cycle energies that give our brass instruments, our higher notes on the piano, give it that kind of spatiality and that, what we call it, separation for the middle and high frequency separation for the normal diffusion, but the higher frequency diffusion, we can get what I'm going to call, it's not very scientific, but it's called sparkle. And we offer a product. It's our mini wood diffusers, which are anywhere from 2 to 3 inches thick. They're made out of solid wood. And if you take them and you position, you have a whole battery ooh, that's a nice sound. You have a whole battery of vertical diffusers across the wall. And then you take a mini diffuser that can have a frequency response of, let's say, 3,000 to 4,000 or even higher, and you position that above the vertical array all around the room. You can really add a lot of lightness, a lot of realism to the note. It almost makes the higher note float in space. And we have some of that in our studio in Hollywood, and we experiment. We take some diffusers down, we add some diffusers, and it's funny because you can get chimes, you can get the higher frequency notes to actually float between the speakers. And it's very, very pleasing to hear. And you can accomplish that with higher frequency diffusers. So when you get more sophisticated in your designing and you get more sophisticated in your treatment applications in your room, and you get more budget, because higher frequency diffusers are made out of solid wood, they're very expensive. So you need quite a bit of them to cover the surface area. So get your 200 to 3400, 3450 taken care of with normal vertical and horizontal diffusion. But if you want to add a little increased dimension and increased sparkle to your presentation, you can look at higher frequency diffusion. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. And if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to. So please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.